Spirulina is a blue-green algae that is absolutely loaded with nutrients, vitamins, beta-carotene, and although it didn't really come onto the market as a dietary supplement until the 1970s, people have consumed spirulina for hundreds of years. In fact, the Aztecs in Mexico and people living in the Lake Chad area in Africa have used spirulina for centuries, and it really only became popular again when NASA proposed that it could also be grown for space for use by astronauts. In this video, we'll look at exactly what this blue-green algae is capable of, how it helps in weight loss, and which form of spirulina is best. Is it powder, capsule, tablets, and how to make sure you're getting the best quality of spirulina, because you may or may not know, spirulina products can contain microcystins, which are known to be toxins that can be harmful. So definitely stay tuned till the end of the video, because we'll be covering all of this. Hi guys, you've seen our Salon Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. If you guys want to learn more about making informed decisions about your health and wellness in an easy to understand way, and if you haven't already subscribed, then I'd love for y'all to click that red subscribe button down below. Also give this video a like if you do enjoy learning about topics like these. Now let's not waste any more time. Let's start with what is spirulina. Spirulina is among the world's most popular supplements. It's known as a biomass of cyanobacteria, known as arthrospira. And in one tablespoon, you get a whopping 4 grams of protein, 1.6 grams of carbs, half a gram of fat, 2 milligrams of iron, and as well as your 21% of your needed copper for the day. At first, people thought that spirulina contains vitamin B12, but this is actually false. It has a pseudovitamin B12, which has not really been shown to be effective in humans. But because it's so jam-packed in other necessary nutrients, magnesium, vitamin C, phosphorus, it's being considered to address global problems like food security, malnutrition, and as a dietary supplement in long-term space flights to Mars. But what about for weight loss? Here's what you need to know. Spirulina can help boost your basal metabolism, and we all know that a higher metabolic rate may increase the number of calories you burn, which leads to weight loss. In this 2014 study, people who took 6 grams of spirulina a day experienced beneficial metabolic effects alongside weight loss and a better health-related quality of life. A larger scale study is needed though, since the participants in the study had non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Secondly, in a meta-analysis of 5 studies, scientists looked at spirulina's effects on weight management in people coping with obesity and found that spirulina did decrease weight in people with obesity by 4.5 pounds and in people who were overweight by 2.8 pounds. And the third reason is that since it's around 60% protein, protein slows down how fast food moves through the digestive system and stabilizes blood sugar levels, which for most people means feeling full longer, as well as not reaching for those Twix bars and Kit Kats we all love. So the next question is how much, the type, and when to take spirulina for maximum weight loss benefits. The dose most companies promote for an adult is 500 milligrams per day, and manufacturers put this into several forms, including the pill form that is common with many other vitamin supplements. Then you have the flake version, which is good for sprinkling onto salads. And then you have my preferred method, which is the powder type, because it's easily mixed into juices and smoothies. And the most ideal time to take spirulina for weight loss is before a meal. Ideally, try hitting a window of 15 minutes to an hour before eating. This is because we can suppress the appetite just enough to keep your food portion size under control, which is a massive factor in weight loss. You won't believe how much portion control can actually do for the waistline. Some people have reported some nausea if they try to use it after a meal, which is why I recommend having it before. Now that we got through how much spirulina, the type of spirulina, and the best time to take it for weight loss, let's look at one of the most important things when it comes to taking spirulina, and that is the quality of the supplement. And with the quality comes the appropriate lab testing that is vital to ensure you're actually getting a safe and effective product, right? Because it's not just the microcystins that are the issue. Heavy metal contamination of spirulina supplements has also raised concern, especially the ones coming out of China. This is what makes independent lab testing even more important. The one I recommend is actually the one by Zazzy, 100% organic spirulina powder, not sponsored at all, but one that I found that is actually free of heavy metals, herbicides, pesticides, fertilizers, and microcystins. You can pick this one up in the description below, so don't forget to check them out below this video. Click the red subscribe button and let me know what your thoughts are down below. Also, give this video a like so I know that you did enjoy it. And if you want me to go over anything else, let me know, as I'd be happy to take suggestions. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.